the streets. And you do not want to be in the streets of New York City with nothing. You don't want to be there because it's cold out there. It's snowing out there. It's bad out there. But I found myself out there, and I had no money. I had no clothes. I didn't have a change of clothes. I hadn't eaten for days. And I got on my knees, and I prayed one prayer. Just one prayer. I said, God, I know that you're real. There was something, and that's what we want tonight. I want to say this, that before you leave here, and anyone that's listening on this broadcast, because just before I came, I looked at a lot of different programs, and I said to myself, God, what is it that you want out of a program that thousands of people are going to be seeing? And I know that what God wants is just, it's not just for you to see another program, because there are a lot of programs. It's not just for you to see another good speaker. There are a lot of good speakers, amen? Not just to hear another singer, but something that will actually change a life. And that's what the Word of God does. And so as I thought about it, and God put this in my heart, He showed me how He changed my life in a split second. I got on my knees that night. When I saw that I was in the streets, I had nothing, was going nowhere. I got on my knees, and it was in front of a lot of people, but I wasn't thinking about the people. You know how sometimes you look around at your neighbors to see what everybody else is doing, to see if you're going to be embarrassed, to see this, that, or the other thing? Not that night. See, when you're down and out and you have nothing and you know that you're going nowhere, it doesn't matter what anybody else has. It doesn't matter who's looking. At that moment, it did not matter. I got on my knees and I said, God, if you will get me out of this place. I was in one of those places down in 42nd Street in New York City where they put the drug addicts and the prostitutes and the people that have nothing. And I was thinking, I was like a prodigal son. I'm not supposed to be here, but I was supposed to be there because that's where I put myself. You know, sometimes you put yourself somewhere. And when I found myself there, like the prodigal son, he said, you know what, I'm going back to my father's house. Glory to God, I knew what to do. And so I turned to God and I said, God, if you get me out of here, I will serve you as long as I live. Let me tell you, the next day, everybody say the next day.
The
next day, glory to God, God made a way for me to get back to my mother's house. And in just a few years, glory to God, I found myself living in Germany, preaching and teaching the Word of God. Few years later, found myself in Italy, preaching the Word of God. Found myself in Spain, preaching the Word of God. Found myself all in all the European nations, in London, England, in Paris, France. I found myself in Czech Republic, names, places that you probably never heard of. Found myself in Africa. Found myself in Israel. Wow. Found myself doing the work of Almighty God because I prayed one prayer.
Yeah.
Wow. I prayed one prayer. And I just want to encourage you tonight, glory to God, if you ever find yourself somewhere where there is no man on earth that can help you, have you ever been there? You see, because sometimes we look for help everywhere but to God. That's why I believe the Lord made me an intercessor, made me a prayer warrior, made me want to pray, because my prayer changed things. God changed my life through prayer, and I believe He will change the life of anybody in here and anywhere in the world if you will pray. Glory to God. I've been in nations. I have a personal interpreter that traveled with me throughout nations. God gave me somebody who spoke languages. Can you imagine that? God gave me people who knows how to go in and out of kingdoms. Glory to God. That's what God will do. How does a little girl from New York City do that? Only God alone. And because we sing about things. We say prayer changes things. We talk about prayer. We go to prayer conferences. I've been to prayer conferences. All they do is talk about prayer. Glory to God. I had a prayer conference and some people came there and I said, okay, let us pray. They couldn't believe it. I said, yeah, we praying. That's here that wanted to do ministry with me some time ago. And she said, I want to travel with you to some of these countries. You see, so sometimes it's just glamorous for folks to travel.
Yeah.
It's glamorous. They think it's glamorous to just get on the plane. But that's because they haven't been in some nations. I was going somewhere one time over in Bosnia. Glory to God. And I was thinking about it. And this was during the time when they had just finished the war. And they had lined up all the men and shot all the men in many of the villages. And they were against Americans. They hated Americans. Glory to God. And it's not like I can hide and try to look European. If I'm in the country, they can more or less pick me out as a foreigner. Amen. Glory to God. And so I was going to Bosnia. And the week before I left, I said, what am I doing? I said, God, when I said I would go, I meant Hawaii. I meant the West Indies. I meant a nice island. I didn't mean Bosnia and places like that. See, so some people like international ministry because it sounds good. They go across the street and they call themselves international ministry. Y'all know what I'm talking about. But I've been to some places. And what I said to my good friend that wanted to travel with me, I said, now you can travel with me because I do that. I have many people that will travel with me to see ministry, to participate in ministry. Right. I teach missionaries and help those who have not seen God do what God really does do.
Yes.
Not just talk about it, but he really does work.
Amen.
But I said to my good friend, but let me tell you something. If you're going to come with me, your jokes won't work in these nations. See, they never heard any of our jokes.
Amen.
You can't just put some nice words together and they're going to be impressed. They won't be impressed by that. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Because that language won't work for them.
Right.
You can't just rhyme. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You can't just preach it like that. They never heard, they never heard that.
Okay.
That don't mean anything to them. Word that will change their lives. They need somebody who have been in the face of God.
Yes.
And so that when you come in their faces, sometimes just your presence.
Yes.
Glory to God. We don't have to just talk about Moses, but your actual presence.
Yes.
In the room will change something because you've been in the presence of Almighty God. That's what some places and some nations need. Hallelujah. And I would venture to say that's what the United States need today.
Yeah.